big shadow that hangs over all of us is the what if. What if I shows up at our house? What if I shows up at the workplace? What if I'm taking my kid to school and I'm being followed? We've had, and this is not an exaggeration, this is true, a suicide or a suicide attempt every month since October, and it's all young people. And I'm not saying that's directly connected to what's going on in immigration and lack of immigration reform and the threats that come from Homeland Security and ICE and DHS, the stress that's on people. I think it's an indicator. They're all young people. The latest was a 12-year-old girl who tried to kill herself. And I went to see her in the hospital yesterday. And people are afraid. And just a tremendous weight and stress. What if, what if, what if? And it's because people are at home here. This is their home. Their parents came here, some as young children, grew up here, children born here. There was a conversation in the sacristy before the mass not long ago. We have altar servers, and of course they're from El Salvador, they're from Guatemala, Mexico, they're from Ecuador. And the conversation when you're in the fifth grade should be, what's your favorite sporting team? What songs you listen to? What are they talking about? Clothes? You know what their conversation was about? They're saying, if my mom gets deported, she said, don't worry because we'll talk every day on Skype. A girl said, my parents have already assigned me a legal guardian. It's my aunt, and she has custody of me in case something should happen. And one kid says, I have no idea what to do. Should my family be doing something? What's going to happen to me? So when you're in the fifth grade, I don't think you need that kind of stress and pressure. You shouldn't be thinking about what's going to happen when ICE takes my family.
The line in the sand seems to be drawn between illegal and legal, undocumented and documented. It just seems to be, that's the tone of this country. How difficult is it to, or do you think it's possible to reach some kind of agreement and maybe not have that line in the sand? Just your thoughts on that.
We almost did it in 2008. We almost got there with immigration reform. It was just almost there. I don't know if we can get there again easily, especially with a lot of the rhetoric. I think it starts with changing the narrative, changing the dialogue, the conversations that people are having. My parishioners are not criminals. Folks from Mexico, Guatemala, Honduras, Ecuador, El Salvador. They're good people, good church-going people. They contribute to society by paying taxes, by working hard, educating their children. So I think the line in the sand is, we fear what and who we don't know, honestly. And the more we hang on to stereotypes and that narrative that, you know, criminal, immigrant drug trafficker, immigrant who's a rapist, immigrant who's here to steal your job, immigrant who's here to take advantage of our systems. As long as we hang on to that, we're going to fear our immigrant brothers and sisters. We'll grow to despise them and even hate them. So we have to tell the story of our immigrant families, moms, dads, children, grandmoms, granddads. We have to tell that story and just keep telling it over and over again. These are people.